This is Sky One, a part of the British Sky Broadcasting Network.
Please welcome the keeper of Cupid's questions. It's the very cuddly Bruno Brooks.
Thank you. Fantastic. Well, a lovely studio audience. Hello and good evening. Welcome to Love at First Sight on Sky One, where the fun is. Six contestants all playing for love and romance very shortly on this very stage. So stay exactly where you are. And to bring them on, here's the lovely Helen Brumby!
How are you?
Fine. Yeah, I've got a funny for you.
What?
What do you call a girl?
You're not going to tell
a
joke.
Yeah, I am. Come on, don't
swear.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
You're not going to tell a joke.
You want me to tell a joke, don't you? Yeah. Well, I'm going to anyway.
Go on.
What do you call a girl with a chimney on her head?
What do you call a girl with a chimney on her head?
Ruth.
Applause, but don't encourage her.
With that, we'll bring on the three girls. Here they are. Right, three dazzling beauties. And who have we got first?
Sarah's motto is always be prepared. Julie had some big tales to tell in the United States. Lucy's a bit of a stunt driver who loves leaning on lampposts.
There you go. Thanks, girls. Keep smiling. You'll need those million-dollar smiles as we bring on the guys. Okay, three fellas, and who is first, Helen?
Simon writes lovely, loving, romantic love songs. Jason had a smelly summer season as a nappy tester. Roof is looking for a girl who's just like his mum.
Give him a hand, yes, yes. Sheer talent on the show tonight, good looks, talent, everything there is to make a perfect partner. Now, we're going to say hello to Sarah, first of all, whose motto is always be prepared. Why is that, then?
Well, I used to be a cub leader, you see, and the motto for the cubs is be prepared.
That's right. So you are really then an Arkalar, really, aren't you?
Well, not quite.
Female one.
The best.
Nice to see you. We've got Julie in the middle there, who has done a bit of travelling. You went to America, didn't you? But apparently you were telling them a few fibs in America to get you by.
Well, you see, I didn't have enough money left at the end of camp, you see. And so what I did was I was going around telling everybody I was a hairdresser that I could cut their hair and raise money to pay the bills.
And you'd never...
So I told a few lies.
You'd never touched a pair of scissors before in your life until...
Well, no, my sister's the hairdresser, that's where I got the idea.
Yeah, you didn't cut Helen's hair, did you, earlier on?
You cruel, heartless thing.
No, I was only kidding, no, really. But I did owe you that one, didn't I? Anyway, nice to see you. We've got Lucy on the end. Lucy is a stunt driver and leans on the lamppost. There's obviously a connection somewhere, but I'm not sure where it is. You could tell us.
I was on my way back to college one day and stepped a little too hard on the brake, did a 360, managed to knock down a concrete lamppost. Luckily, I was OK.
You're OK, but the car wasn't, obviously.
No, it needed a little bit of body work.
Repair, let's say, that's right. Well, there's some body work over here, by the looks of it. Simon, first of all, who writes romantic songs, is that right?
Yeah, it's true, it's true. I've got a bit of a problem, though, cos I always use the girl's name in the song and they usually have to write them after I've split up with them, so I can never sing them to anybody because I can't sing it to them.
We really are feeling for you, Simon.
Nobody's ever heard any of them yet.
Yeah, until tonight. Jason's there in the middle, who's a nappy, or at least you were a nappy tester.
I wasn't a nappy tester. It's one of the most exciting things I've ever done in my life.
Really?
Going into work day after day, unwrapping the boxes and just taking out millions of nappies and testing them.
Surely one of the smelliest things you've ever done in your life as well, was it?
Well, yeah, it was.
All right, I've got Roop here on the end. Hello, Roop, who's looking for a girl just like your mum. Is that right?
Well, almost. You see, my mother is a bit unusual for parents.
Yeah, it sort of runs in the family, doesn't it?
if my dad's anything like you, it does. But it's my mum's a... No, my mum's a 44-year-old student, unbelievably. And drives around like a maniac in a red Volvo.
Nearly at the end of, end of part one. Anyway, good to have you on the show. Now, we've got to get some questions now, questions.
Wake me up. I think Simon might have to write a love song.
OK, Simon, here's your first question, and it's coming up to the first anniversary of the day you met your partner, OK? Have you got the date? One, imprinted in your heart. Two, written in your diary. Or three, were you even aware it was your anniversary?
I would know it was the anniversary. Do I have to give a number here?
No, you don't. Just tell me why.
I would know it was the anniversary, but I am the world's worst organised person, so I would like remember like a month before, 2 weeks before, a week before, probably forget on the day, and remember at 5:15 when the shops are about to shut. I would get something sorted.
Right. Do you keep a diary?
Yeah, but I keep it 200 miles from where I live, so that's not much
better. That's no good, is it? What about everybody else? How would you choose? It's coming up to the first anniversary of the day you met your partner. Have you got the date imprinted in your heart, written in your diary, or were you not even aware it was your anniversary in the first place? Choose now one of those three answers to that question there. Sarah has a diary, obviously. You would write it in the diary.
I don't really keep a diary, but, it wouldn't be imprinted on my heart.
It wouldn't.
It depends.
What sort of things? I mean, who keeps a diary here? Just stick your hand up very quickly. OK, I'm going to come to you, Julie. You keep a diary.
I've been keeping one since I was 11, actually.
Have you really?
Yeah.
It must be really interesting to look back at.
It is. That's exactly why I keep it. Look back at the day of all these birthdays, things like that.
Do you have code for your diary?
No, I don't, but it's certainly got a key.
All right, let's go for another question. Come on, let's keep these questions rolling.
We've got to go to Roop for this one.
To Roop. OK, which Muppet character do you most identify with? Is it one, Kermit the Frog, two, Miss Piggy, or another Muppet?
Well, I'd go for another one, but it's going to be Miss Piggy, because, again, that's my mother, straight out. I'm sorry, Mum.
You ought to be. She's got to clout you around the ear when she gets you later on. Everybody else, go on. Which Muppet character do you most identify with? Kermit the Frog, Miss Piggy, or another Muppet? Choose now. Go for it. And if it's not a Muppet, maybe it's another cartoon character. We'll look around and see what we got. Simon, Miss Piggy?
Yeah, it's just a rumour. I know I've been seen around with somebody, but I'd be foolish to deny it. It is Miss Piggy I've been seen with.
Right, OK. What about you, Jason? You've gone for Kermit the Frog.
Kermit is just a is a hero of mine from a youngster, so I just have to go for Kermit.
Do you think he looks like... Do you look like him, or...?
Well, how rude. No.
I only asked that question, that's all.
He looks like Fuzzy Bear.
He does, doesn't he?
Fuzzy Bear.
Fuzzy Bear. And Lucy, what about you? Miss Piggy, you think you look like Miss Piggy? I wouldn't have thought that for a million moments.
I don't think I look like Miss Piggy, Bruno, but I think I'm probably as mouthy as Miss Piggy. And anybody that knows me will know that I'm certainly game for a laugh, and I'm not joking. If we're in the bar, I'm usually leading in the crowd that's making all the noise in the corner somewhere.
Come on, then, give me another question. Let's speed this up a little bit.
Let's go to the girls. Julie.
Julie, have you ever seen a ghost? Have you ever seen a ghost? Yes, no, or perhaps? You were never quite sure.
Well, that would definitely have to be perhaps, because the other day, I'm very much into the occult. I read all the books like that. I think it's fascinating things. But the other day, I was sitting in my room, and, like, I was just doing some of my homework, and my cactus plant, which is sitting by my fishbowl, just... The fish had just died, so that's a bit of a coincidence. Just flew across the room, all over the floor, and there was mud everywhere. That freaked me out, so it must be perhaps.
How strange. Hope you don't invite him back to your house. Another question, or should we have a quick vote for everybody on this one? What would you choose? Have you ever seen a ghost? Yes, no, or perhaps? Choose now. Go on, then. All right, then, Sarah, you've never seen a ghost at all.
No, I've never seen
Do you believe in them?
Yes and no.
Right, but you don't believe you've seen one. Has anyone seen a ghost here? Put your hand up if you've seen a ghost. No one's seen a ghost at all?
But it could have been our cat.
It could have been
your cat. It could have been the
cat. Right, OK.
At least it wasn't his mum.
Thanks for coming on the show, Roop. You're great. All right, now it's time to choose each other. You've got to find a perfect partner. That's what the show is all about. Take a last fleeting glance at some pretty girls, some handsome guys, and you've got to choose each other. So, fingers on the button and make your ideal choice right now. What a strange face you got, Emma. See you in 2 minutes after the break. See you then.
This is McPike style section, 1300 hours. He's loose.
And he's dangerous. Vincent Terranova, a highly trained undercover agent, infiltrating the most dangerous crime organizations.
Listen, this thing's gonna get ugly fast. Tom McPike, there's gonna be a shootout unless he can fall on it fast.
Don't miss Wise Guy, Thursday at 9 on Sky One.
Keep on running. Keep on hiding. One fine day I'm gonna be the one to make you understand. Oh yeah, I'm gonna be your man. Keep on running.
The Citroen AX GT. It's full of surprises.
Oh, Elspeth, will you be it? My wife, I mean.
I will.
Yeah. For you. Dime buzzer forever.
Crisp butter almond and smooth milk chocolate.
Well,
you never forget your first dime.
Unbelievable. How often do we clear out this cabinet?
We don't clear it out at all.
Look, I've got a headache, I'm late for work.
I can't find the paracetamol. What's this then?
Anadin.
Anadin paracetamol.
Why didn't you say so in the first place? Oh, look at that.
Easy to swallow.
Anadin paracetamol, the paracetamol with a micro-thin coating.
I'm off.
Have a good day.
I will.
He will.
Anadin paracetamol, strong on pain, gentle on you.
Hot on the heels of the Citroën AX GT is the AX Miami. Yours for the surprisingly low price of £5,390.
Meet Parker Lewis, his sister.
Hey, Park, forgot to take the trash out this morning.
You made it to school all right, didn't you?
His best friend, Mikey.
Park, this is bogus.
And his headmistress.
Until the last bell rings this Friday, you're mine.
Detention, 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 detention.
Yet even with all these odds, Parker Lewis can't lose. Why? Find out Saturday at 6 on Sky One.
Hello, welcome back to the show. Here we are on Love at First Sight. Doing a little bit and bringing people together so they can go out for a meal, get to know each other and come back and play with those wonderful prizes, including that fantabulous love trip. That's the one. OK, now, thank you to Cupid, of course, stores all the information for us, and thank you also to Mrs. Shirley Linehan, I think that's right, from Harlow in Essex, who sent us this suggestion as to what she thinks Cupid stands for, C-U-P-I-D. Casanovas usually prosper in dating. Very, very clever indeed. Thank you, Shirley, for that. We will send you a bottle of the one and only Love at First Sight massage oil. That's exactly why you sent it in. We will send you that in return, as promised, all right? Keep your suggestions coming in. We've got to start off now, let's see, with Lucy. Lucy, which of these three guys was the one for you? Oh, Lucy went for Roop. Why did you go for Roop?
I think his mum sounds like good fun. No, I'm from Agricultural College and he looks like he could probably fit in our bar.
He could.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
He'd have a good time.
Does he look the farming type to you? Does it sort
yeah,
of
I mean, the
guy...
jacket, yeah. Yeah. Chinos, yeah.
Well, my dad lived on a farm, so perhaps something's rubbed off.
Yeah. Okay, then. Well, we'll find out whether Roop fancies Lucy in a big way. Here we go, is the answer. Roop went for Sarah. Now tell us why you went for Sarah, Roopy.
Well, people say that boys go after girls who remind them of their mothers. Well, I'm afraid... Well, no, I'm afraid in this case it's not true. It's not true, right? Anyway, I fancy her. Simple as that.
Yeah. Roop, I know a very good doctor, if you're interested.
I'm a nurse.
Yeah, but that could come in handy. Did Sarah go for Roop? Here we go. Yeah! Sight. It seems that way, so you must have a very good reason why you went for Roop then.
Well, he seems to have a fixation about his mother, and I'm used to dealing with little boys.
Oh. Well, I might even stand a chance myself then. Well, there you go. You're going out tonight. Congratulations. And back to play for some prizes, of course, Sarah. So we'll move on now to Jason, the man in the middle over there. Which girl was the one for you, Jace? Right, so why don't you go for Julie?
Well, apart from everything else, I think the colour of her lipstick just matches the colour of my hair.
All right. It's a pity you're colourblind, isn't it? Did Julie go for Jason? Here we have the answer. Simon's just woken up. Why did you go for Simon then, Julie?
Well, I think he's probably one of the best looking lads I've ever seen, and that's the truth.
Really? Is that right? What makes him a very attractive man then?
Well, I like dark lads with dark eyes.
Yeah.
And he's got them both. I like his dress sense.
Yes. I think he's about to cry.
And he shouldn't get big-headed.
Well, there we go. This hopefully could be love at first sight if Simon chooses you, of course, Julie. And Cupid's got the answer. Why did you go for Sarah then, Simon?
Well, I think she's very nice looking, and she said the thing about dealing with the cubs, and I'm always scouting around for a nice girl. I think she's very nice.
Oh, very clever indeed. But, I mean, OK, she's one of three, OK, that you've been offered tonight in many ways.
They're all marvellous.
They're all marvellous, yes, but... but is she the ideal woman for you? I mean, is she somebody that's special? I mean, do you think that she's a special look, or is it just the best of the three?
I don't know. You're making me very nervous, Bruno, putting me on the spot like this. I think she's very nice, very pretty.
Very good indeed. Well, that's what it's all about at the end of the day. We've only got one loving couple on the show tonight. As you know, Sarah's taken by Roop, and that's the way it is. So I want you to give them a nice big cheer. Roop and Sarah, come and join us. Come on. Would you just like to just come and face the camera? And would you just sort of an action replay of that for us on the count of three, please? That
would you like
that peck.
Should we just start from here?
Two, three. Yeah, go for it. Go on. Watch this now. Very nice indeed. Just getting a bit of practice in there. Marvellous. Jason and Simon, thank you for playing the game. Who else have we got? Of course, we've got Lucy and Julie. Thank you as well. Give them a hand, ladies and gentlemen, please. Right then. So they're going out. Where are they going?
Lorenzo's is the name of the restaurant, and Lorenzo himself is the head chef. As you might have gathered, Lorenzo specialises in the finest Italian cuisine, so the pair of you can relax and specialise in each other.
Very good indeed. Our love at first sight Ferrari is waiting backstage there, and Helen will tell you exactly where you're going, OK?
I'm driving.
That's right. Have a nice night. Give them a nice round of applause. Thank you very much. Very good. Well, success once again. We've got a loving couple on this very show, Love at First Sight. That's exactly why we're here. And it happens all the time, every single night. I mean, do you remember when this couple fell in love at first sight?
Well, something I didn't mention is I'm in the territorials, and with her doing SAS-style attacks, I jumped through a bay window for her any time.
Well, apart from the fact I like flat-top haircuts, the way to my heart is through my belly, and when he mentioned spaghetti bolognese, that was it. That was it. It's my favourite.
That's just for starters, is it?
That's just for starters.
Okay. Michelle is from London and Mark is from Leighton Buzzard, and they're back as a loving couple on Love at First Sight! Well, he hasn't been taking you for a ride, has he?
Certainly has.
You're having a lot of fun, it's very obvious, and you look to me as if you're extremely close.
We are.
Well, really? I think we are, definitely.
Yeah?
Yep.
You made the right choice for each other?
Definitely.
Could this be love at first sight?
Hopefully.
I think so.
It's looking good, isn't it,
it
so
is.
Far?
Yeah.
So, obviously, you did a lot of chatting, didn't you?
Yes.
Wow, a lot of gazing as well.
Gazing. Oh, this is really good. This is what we want from the show. That's why we're here. Now, listen, you're going to win lots of prizes with a bit of luck. We want you to win that love trip, the star prize. Let's be honest, we all want to go away and get a nice suntan. So fingers are crossed, and in a few minutes, you'll find out whether you got it or not. So we'll see you right after this break. See you then.
Can I ask you something personal?
When I was 16, in my dad's car...
On the men's room wall, it said it was under your dad's car.
Tuesday, only on Sky One. A compulsive prescription for medical mayhem.
And your tonsils are no longer inflamed. At least they taste that way.
Tonight, 7:30 on Sky One.
Right, got everything? All ready for the off? Come on. It's the end of the holiday, not the end of the world. I've got to go home sometime. Looks like we'll have to stay then.
Yay!
Butlins, let yourself go, and you won't want to leave. Ringo 800 900 900 for your free Butlins brochure. But remember, you won't want to leave.
A team of professionals.
I'm a sophisticate. I don't drool. I stutter.
What are you based that on?
A hunch, a detective's hunch.
A team willing to do anything.
I'm going to turn this pathetic heap of bones into a finely tuned machine.
To solve the case.
I'm all hooked up.
You're showing a real flair for this, Murray.
Join the Riptide Detectives, Friday at 8 on Sky One.
What do we do now, Batman?
Welcome back to the show with miles and miles of smiles. Look at these smiles, they're wonderful, aren't they? Great stuff. Mark and Michelle are most definitely in love. They've had a long chat. And with a bit of luck, we're now going to find out how much they know about each other, OK? First question to you, Michelle. What is his favourite form of gambling? What's his favourite form of gambling? Right away, Mark. Your favourite form of gambling, you know, if you were asked to go gambling, would you prefer the horses? Would you prefer a casino, maybe? Or a one-armed bandit? What do you think the answer is, Michelle?
Horses.
Horses. What have we got? Not at all. You don't gamble at all?
Nope, no, not at all.
Didn't make a gamble on this one either, did you?
No.
No. Here's a question for you, Mark. Do you think that she saves her money in a bank, a building society, or does she not save at all? Right away, Michelle. In a bank or a building society, she not save at all? Maybe she even saves in a piggy bank. OK, the answer is?
Bank.
No. Oh. Building society. What were you doing that night? You certainly weren't talking to each other, were you? Right then, Michelle, do you think he would cry watching Love Story? Or any other sloppy film? Do you think he'd cry? Is he that type? Bambi. I remember watching Bambi all those years ago, and it was so sad, wasn't it? Do you remember that film? OK, yeah. Well, he's written down the answer, and the answer is...
No.
No! But yes, he would!
He doesn't like to see people seen him cry.
Oh, he's going to end up crying after this. You've got no love heart so far. Listen, I'm going to have to help you a little bit if you carry on like this. Would she have the nerve to ring up a Radio 1 phone-in? Would she have... Just put the 1 in there, by the way. Would she have the nerve to ring up a Radio 1 phone-in? Yes, Radio 1, here we are on the line now, and coming up on the line is Michelle. Is she on the line, yes or no? And the answer is...
Yes.
Yes! OK, you got one love heart. You only need one chance to get the love trip, so you're more or less there. A question now for you, Michelle. Which of these would he prefer on his toast? Marmalade, jam or beans? Right away, Mark, for us. Marmalade, jam or beans? Hopefully not all at the same time. So the answer is...
Marmalade.
Yeah, that'll do. And a final question now. You've got two love hearts, hopefully a third one on the way. What do you think is her best swimming stroke? What do you think is her best swimming stroke? The eyes are going here. I've got to be careful, haven't I? Michelle? All right, now... OK, Mark, what do you think?
I'll take a guess and say breaststroke.
Yes, you're right! It's a good guess, that means you have three love hearts. Well, right off to a wonderful location. Fingers crossed, will you be going on this love trip? You're jetting away on an Italian escapade thanks to the company of the same name. Your trip will consist of a week together at the spectacular four-star Marini Strand Hotel, which is situated in the very heart of the eternal city, Rome itself. And as you wing your way home on your Italian sky shuttle trip, there'll be sweet memories of Dolce Vita on this love trip. There you go, those are those love trip tickets with the lovely Helen, who's made yet another change. And give us a rundown of prizes on the love board.
Well, we've got some jewellery, some coat-to-coat knitwear, a Sloan helicopter ride.
Great.
A cordless telephone, cassette alarm, boot 17 makeup, the love trip, and the massage oil.
Some great prizes, and even other prizes on the board, believe it or not, as well. Remember to keep away from that broken heart. We don't want to see you with a broken heart. You're too nice, you're too lovely. You deserve more than that. You've got three of the hearts, all because you knew each other very well on that evening together over that romantic dinner. And you going to do the firing, Mark, are you?
I've been told I've got to.
Well, by Michelle, no doubt. So hands on the love throttle, then. Here we go. Good luck. 12 seconds starting now.
Any lady will really cut a dash in this pair of fun sweaters from the Coat to Cone range of knitwear. Each individual design will complement your own wacky personality.
Yeah! You get a blue one, a pink one. You can have the blue one, Mark. Michelle, you can have the pink one. You look great together, wouldn't you, in those? Especially this time of the year. So, right then, a few more questions and two more hearts. You ready? Right, shoot for the next one.
It's the Morphe Richards cassette alarm, which will have you waking in a merry mood. It has dual alarm and a choice of radio or cassette. Happy listening!
Yeah! And don't forget, on the FM dial, because it's an FM radio cassette, that one, and of course there is this great show on the radio at the weekends, as a matter of fact. Do you actually get up early at the weekends, do you?
Sometimes.
You do, don't you?
Sometimes.
You switch on Radio 1 every single time, don't you?
Adrian Just.
Well, do you mean Adrian Just? Tell you, he's on in the afternoon. Hello, Adrian, if you're watching. Right, you've got 7 seconds then for one final heart. You've kept yourself away from the broken heart so far. And remember, the love trip's on there somewhere. Let's hope that you choose the right heart. When you're ready, 7 seconds, starting now. You got it! Absolutely brilliant! Come on, give him a cheer! Ladies and gentlemen, they are off to Rome in Italy! Well done, brilliant stuff. And of course, Rome is a fantastic city. It's such a stylish place. And you'll be able to go and have lunch with the Pope at the Vatican and all that sort of stuff. Brilliant stuff. You've got the other two prizes, the radio cassette, and you've got those jumpers. You're so excited, aren't you? Absolutely great. Give another nice round of applause. Absolutely wonderful. Oh, there's going to be some celebrating tonight, I tell you, and they really deserve it because they're really nice and they do love each other. They've already said it on the show. Listen, thanks very much for watching. Look after yourself, and we'll see you next time on this show. That's Love at First Sight. See you then.